And now I will try to talk about the features of radar and how I can use this sensor, this active sensor, to monitor the volcanic ash cloud. This is the typical scenario. Then the radar will serve the activity, eruptive activity, and the radar, thanks to the agility in the elevation, in azimuth, in range, can to probe the volcanic plume. Within the plume, we can find different type of tephra, then from the dust, ash, lapilli, bomb, each one characterized by different size, distance from the volcano vent, the residence time in the atmosphere. And this is the typical way the radar can detect the plume. Then the radar send an electromagnetic wave through the antenna, and when this electromagnetic wave detect the particles present in the plume, can backscatter the radiation, and then the radar can receive this quantity. After the elaboration, we can obtain the output, such as this image, then the information about the typology of particle, density, etc. We can find four main subsystems within the radar system. That is the sensor subsystem, where we can observe the different features related to the antenna. The processor subsystem, where the data, the raw data is elaborated. The communication subsystem. And the last one is the product subsystem, where the data are stored and processed. And we can affirm that the radar send a train of short, is a short pulse, then is a train of short pulse with high power. And typically the radar operated to gigahertz, then the high frequency. And when this quantity is detected by the particle is partially absorbed and re-radiated in any direction. And we can observe the main features of this pulsed signal. Very important is the pulse width, because starting from this information, we can define the resolution of a radar. And when we talk about the microwave radar, we talk about this quantity, then the range resolution, that is the ability of a radar to detect two or more different targets in the same beam, range beam. The maximum unambiguous range is the maximum distance that the radar can observe a target, because typically the radar is able to scan the volume around itself till a distance of 100, 200 kilometers far from the site of the radar. And it's able to scan an altitude between 15, 20 kilometers above sea level. The other information very important is the pulse repetition frequency. That is the time where the radar can send this train of pulses. And the other quantity is the average transmitted power, that is weighted with the duration of the pulse width and the time of repetition of different signal. The microwave radar are typically the Doppler system, and then this system is able to observe the target at moving And then we can observe that this translation, this shift in the frequency can change. And typically, if the target is leaving, we can observe a frequency Doppler frequency decreasing or increasing if the target is approaching. The other main feature of microwave radar is the polarization, because we talk about a polarimetric system. Then the radar sends an electromagnetic wave polarized. And starting from the information derived from both wavelength, horizontal, vertical polarization, we can retrieve information about the shape of the particle, then the target detected by the radar. And when we talk about weather radar, then the radar to monitor the event, volcanic event, we talk about of pulse volume resolution. That is the small volume detected by the radar in the range. And then we can retrieve the information, the observables, such as the radar reflectivity, the polarization, related to a small volume. And if we talk about a single target, we can observe the different typical quantities that you can find in a radar system. And then the incident density of power, the radar cross-section, that is the elementary surface of a target detected by the electromagnetic wave, and then is responsible of the electromagnetic wave that is backscattered. The received power, this relation very important, because we can retrieve from this last equation, the radar equation. The radar equation is that, and then we can observe the radar cross-section is a feature related to the target, the distance, the term of loss in the path in the radar system, and the different features related to the electronic component, then the features of the antenna of a radar. But when we talk of scanning LIDAR with a radar, we talk about a distributed target. Then we conserve different target within this volume. And then we talk mainly to volumetric reflectivity. It is an weighted quantity related to the cross-section of target in the volume, in the elementary volume. It's the same relation see before, but in this case we observe this other quantity, this volumetric reflectivity. Then we try to retrieve the information about of dispersion of particle in this elementary volume. And the typical observables that we can use to retrieve information about of volcanic plume in this case is the radar reflectivity factor that is the main correlated to the size of particle and the distribution of the particle in this volume. The differential radar reflectivities is an information, is an observables sensitive to the shape of particle. The correlation coefficient is sensitive to the heterogeneity of dispersed particle in the volume. The differential propagation phase shift is another quantity very important, because allow us to retrieve information about the shape size of a particle. And mainly we use a scaled scale gamma particle size distribution. Then we suppose to observe a distribution of a particle in the elementary volume beam. And we consider this typical distribution for the particle. And here we can observe the main features of radar, of particles detected by the radar in terms of observables, such as radar reflectivity, correlation coefficient, shift differential reflectivity for four different size ash class, different kind of particles, considering also three different orientation, oblate, prolate, tumbling. And then we can try to use this information to apply a Bayesian algorithm in order to retrieve the main features of particle. But we need to highlight this information, that is, the radar is able to observe the minimum detectable signal, but the signal is linked to the distance. Then when the distance is increasing, the minimum signal that the radar is able to detect is decreasing. This is the typical flow diagram of Bayesian detection using the algorithm. And then this is related to the model, the numerical model. Then using the information about the radar, then the radar specification and the hash a priori data, we can insert this information in the numerical model to obtain the synthetic observables. And we use this information to train the algorithm in terms of classification, where we can find here the measurement of radar. And after the classification, we can try to retrieve the main features in terms of concentration in the emitter, et cetera, the other different information. In this case, in the script that in MATLAB script program that I will show you soon, we use the regressive law to retrieve the concentration, the mean diameter. These information are derived from the paper of Ulpiani. And in this case, we consider an only one big size class and one size concentration. And then we use this regressive law to retrieve the information starting only from the radar reflectivity factor. And knowing the scanning strategy of the radar, then it's able to observe the volume around itself operating in elevation and azimuth. We show you in the algorithm two main results, that is the image, the range 8 indicator, that is a vertical section of plume along a specific azimuth, and the vertical maximum index, it is a projection, vertical projection of the plume in the horizontal plane. It's the typical result that you can observe as a result of this script. Then we try to apply this simplified algorithm. Then we starting from the information or radar reflectivity factor, we try to estimate the concentration, the mean diameter. You can download the folder from the home page of conference. The name is the radar training activity. We can find in this folder other folders with the radar input data. In this case, you can observe here the radar reflectivity factor matrix that is related to the last case of Etna eruption, but is a data, realistic data that to be calibrated. And in the folder MATLAB script function, you can find the main script, the main program that invoke the different function to obtain a different result. Now I move in the my MATLAB. Okay. Then if you open the program, you can find the main, that is the X-Radar Lab Etna. It's a live script.
Sorry, Luigi, I don't know if you want to share your MATLAB or not, your MATLAB window or not, because you are still sharing the PowerPoint.
Ah, sorry. I can share my... now you see my MATLAB screen or no?
We see something frozen. Frozen.
Ah. Not yet.
Allora, now I try again. Allora. qui. I share. Okay, perfect. Now?
Cool. Yeah.
Perfect. Okay. This is the main script. Then, firstly, I load the different input data, that is the matrices of different coordinates. And the output is the matrix of concentration, the mean diameter, the image related to these quantities, and the image of top plume altitude. There is also a short function to estimate this quantity. And if you start the algorithm, I fix a breakpoint in the line. Okay, 75, start. Then the algorithm start to loading the different data available in the table. Okay, then we can survey the different in the workspace of MATLAB scheme. We can serve the different data loaded, then the matrix of range, latitude, longitude. This is the very important is the matrix, or rather reflectivity factor, is a four-dimensional matrix. Then if you click on with a double click, you can try to open this data. And you can see here that I commented this function that is a video or reflectivity. And if you go in this function, you can observe that I try to create a video of different vertical maximum index of radar reflectivity factor. Then we observe the motion of the plume in the time. I try to share this video because you can find this output in the main folder. I see. Okay, you see my screen now?
We see the window with the command window of the editor window of MATLAB.
And now?
No, it's still
okay, the MATLAB. I need to change the screen. Sorry, one moment. And stop. Now I try to open the video. Okay, sure.
Yes.
Stop.
Yes.
Okay, start again. Then we can observe the vertical maximum index in the time. Then I try to observe the dynamic of the plume detected by the radar. 8:22:09 is the time that I selected to observe the activity of this eruption, and then we can find this time for a different image. And we observe the total dynamic of the plume, this plume. And the function that we have shown you before is related to this video. Okay, share again. We go back to main and breakpoint here, continue. And now in this algorithm, and then we can select a different time to observe the vertical maximum index of reflectivity or concentration or mean diameter if you want. Okay. And the function plot of VMI plot RHI. Two functions allow us to observe the same image in this case of video, and function plot RHI allow us to observe the vertical section along specific azimuth of plume. It's very interesting because we can observe the internal structure of plume. Then with different color or hot or cold color, we can observe the intensity of particle, then intensity of reflectivity, then we can suppose the different kind of particle within the plume. I don't know if the algorithm, okay, perfect. Okay, then we can observe in this picture the different vertical section along specific azimuth of plume, and then we can observe the variability or rather reflectivity factor. Then here we can suppose find the event, the Etna event for this eruption. And then we conserve the different selected the time, the different vertical section along specific azimuth angle. Now we try to obtain the information about the concentration and mean diameter, and then invoke this other function. This function you can see here is the function that uses the coefficient for the regressive flow. And in this case, we can retrieve this information starting from the reflectivity, radar reflectivity factor. The radar reflectivity factor that I send you is the matrix of in a logarithmic scale. Then we need before to translate it in the linear scale, and then we apply this power law. And we can retrieve the this main feature. My computer is no, so rapid. And then we can retrieve this information about the concentration and in diameter. The quantity present here are derived from this paper, and we invoke also the function is the plot VMI for the concentration and mean diameter. Then we can observe the vertical projection of different estimation, but before, yeah. Before you can observe the histogram of concentration, and then we can observe the trend of a different estimation, then the concentration range between 0 to 10, 11 gram to meter to the third. And for the mean diameter, we conserve the variation between 0 and 3-4 millimeter. And invoking this in function, we conserve the vertical projection in the horizontal plane for the time 20 to 9 a.m. For the concentration and mean diameter. And now I comment this quantity, I hope. And I go to this function, top plume estimation, and yeah. And in this case, we try to retrieve the top plume altitude, considering for each instant time. We try to detect the maximum reflectivity in the altitude. And then with this threshold algorithm on radar reflectivity factor, we can detect the maximum reflectivity in the elevation. When we find this information in the time, we select the height related to the beam. And then we can retrieve the maximum altitude of plume in the time. This is a possible approach because we use directly the radar reflectivity factor that is the first observables that you can obtain from the radar. But if you want, you can try to estimate this quantity starting from the concentration. Then in this case, I can apply an threshold algorithm on concentration if you want. Then there is different possibility to retrieve this very important information. In this case, we use directly the reflectivity. Okay, this is the different vertical section of concentration and mean diameter. Okay, perfect. This is the output of the function top plume height. Then you can observe the trend of top plume altitude detected by this algorithm. At the end, if you want, you can invoke this app of MATLAB, Volume Viewer, that allows us to observe the three-dimensional matrix of reflectivity, of concentration on diameter. I try to start this function and another screen I will open, I hope. Then it is an very important, very interesting function of MATLAB. In this case, we observe the information about the wall structure of a plume as detected in terms of the reflectivity of the retrieval, such as the concentration. And we can move this image in the space, and then you can rotate the image, you can zoom this image, and then you can observe also, if you want, the internal structure of the plume. Then it's very interesting function of MATLAB, but I don't know if my computer can open this function. I don't know. I don't know if possible with my computer now. In this case, you can obtain this image. You see my screen now?
We just see okay. MATLAB.
Window. Ah, okay, MATLAB. Doesn't work. And you can obtain this image. The image is this image of plume. Okay, this is an simple function of MATLAB to obtain this image. You can move in the window to change the rotation and the angle to observe the plume. Okay, that was all. If you want, you can try to run the script because the function, the data are available in the folder. You can find this information in the homepage of conference.